What's good? It's your boy CJ Goodfella back with the boxing clinic. And, you know, Curtis Showtime Stevens versus David Lemieux this Saturday. I think it's on HBO Latino. Eurykios Gamboa is on the undercard. It's in Verona, New York, which I think has held a lot of classic fights, a lot of mid-level classic fights. And you know, this is the fight that you want to show your friends that are borderline or casual or non-boxing fans that can really convert them into hardcore-ism boxing fan. You know what I mean? This is going to be an exciting shootout. You know, both guys have been knocked out before. Both guys have a lot of power. And both guys have zero versatility in the boxing game. You know what? I say Curtis Stevenson can box a little bit. You know, he had a little good showing versus Golovkin. He had his moments. And David Lemieux had nothing but a one-dimensional fighter. So, but if you look at the fight, you know, strategy-wise, it's pretty tough to call. You know, what Stevenson is, you know, he always likes to follow his opponent around the ring, especially if he's a boxer. But that's not going to be the case here. I don't see Lemieux getting on his bike, using his jab at all. He is what he is. And it's going to be a straight-up bully, meet you in the ring of a fight, and who can really survive the toughest, who has the best chin, who's in the best shape. And I think that's going to really much depend on who can take each other's power. And I think Lemieux not being able to box on the outside is really going to be a detriment to his him in this fight. You know, we've seen Lemieux get knocked out versus Marco Antonio Rubio, who's not the biggest puncher, has some big knockouts, but he's not the biggest puncher. We've seen them both get knocked out, Stevenson and Lemieux knocked out by Golovkin. And, you know, Lemieux showed a hell of a chin because he took a lot of shots to the face and a lot of jabs. Curtis Stevenson showed a hell of a chin, you know. And this is my, in the way this fight's going to play out, especially if it's in close corners and mid-range, it really much favors Stevenson because he has the shorter arms. And he's the shorter, more stockier fighter. And I think the fighter who actually bangs the body more and then mixes a head attack with it is probably going to win. And I think who has the most heart. You know, strategy-wise, that shit going out the window. I couldn't even tell you strategy-wise, you know, what they're going to do. You know what I mean? Pretty much, what they're going to do if somebody come out and box on the back foot, or I don't see neither one of them guys doing that. This is just going to be a straight-out savage war. And, you know, that's what HBO likes to put on. This fight has been in a year in the making. Like I said, it's going to be close corners with the shorter arms. It favors Stevens. He doesn't have a lot of body here because he's short. He really has the height of a lightweight or a junior welterweight. And Lemieux is the bigger fighter, but Lemieux, you know, sometimes lacks some dog in him. And he likes to tire out in fights. You know, Curtis Stevens, you know, I never really see him stop trying in the fight. You know, I know Jesse Brinkley punked him out. I know Darrell, you know, danced around him and outclassed him. I know Nadal outboxed him, but he's not going to get outboxed by David Lemieux. I can't see Lemieux changing his stripes and, you know, becoming a boxer. He's the guy that's going to go out there, unload it all. You know, Stevenson's the guy that's going to unload it all. At least I know Stevenson will, you know, use that jab a little bit and move a little bit. He's more prone to do that than Lemieux, but he's not going to do that either. I think, like I said, the guy that goes to the body more, who has the better stamina, and I think Stevens has the better heart and the better chin at the end of the day at this weight. I think, you know, it's going to win this fight. You know, when I first picked this fight, I thought I was going to go with David Lemieux, but I pretty much talked myself into this video. I'm going to go with Curtis Stevens by a 6-round TKO to stop David Lemieux. I really don't always go with Stevens because he always comes up short in the big fights. And Lemieux has been looking good as of lately, coming back after the Golovkin loss. But I think Stevens is more likely to bang that body and then go upstairs with some good shots and get Lemieux out of there. But I wouldn't pretty bet my house on either one of these guys. And I look forward to this fight. This is going to be one of the great fights of the weekend. We're going to get into the Demetrius Jack Coakland prediction. I really wasn't going to do that, but I'm going to get into that tomorrow. Please, everybody, tune in and watch this fight this weekend if you have some time or DVR it. It's going to be a classic. We're going.